Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss chapter vector for class 11th physics. In this week chapter we are going to study about the what is this vector quantities, what is scalar quantities, how this scalar quantities added, multiplied, divide, how this vector quantities is added, multiplied, subtract and divide, and what are the use of vector quantities in our daily life. So we are going to start the chapter. This term vector and scalar you have already studied or familiar in class 9. In class 9 you have already studied about the what is this scalar quantity and what is this vector quantities. As you know that all the physical quantities are expressed with the help of a standard unit. Then those unit explain about the quantities, whether these quantities are which type. So this all physical quantities are classified into two groups. These all are classified into two groups, and they are the scalar quantities as well as the vector quantities. What is this scalar quantities? A scalar quantities are those quantities which have only its magnitude and no direction. It means it does not have any direction. They are known as the scalar quantities. So if you want to write out time, mass, length, etc., it does not have any direction. It has its only magnitude. It has its only its numeral value. Suppose that if you want to write down its 2 kg, then 2 kg only its magnitude is showing its, it is the mass of any particle, and that is in the number of 2. This physical unit, this unit is in 2 multiple, 2 kg. It does not have any direction. So it is specified by a single number and no proper unit. It means it is specified by single number and proper unit. All the scalar quantities are specified by its numeral value and its single proper unit. Whenever you want to represent the any scalar quantities, any type of scalar quantities, you should write down the numeral value and its proper unit. When you write down the proper unit, then we can say that which type of physical quantities are there. Now, second is the vector. What is this vector? Those physical quantities which have its magnitude as well as its direction. Those physical quantities which have its magnitude as well as its direction are known as vector quantities. These vector quantities, if we write down the velocity and if we write down the speed, then this speed does not have any specified direction. But when we write down velocity, then velocity has its magnitude as well as its direction. It means the vehicle, the particle, the body is moving in which direction, that is already specified with this unit. So whenever we want to write down velocity, so this velocity has its direction. Just like a displacement, you have already studied in the class 9 distance and displacement. Then this distance does not have any proper direction, it has its only length. But displacement, it has its direction. It means the particle is moving in, displacing in which direction. So this displacement is also a vector quantity. Now how can we represent this vector quantity? It is specified by single number. It means it also required single number and with proper unit and direction. Here once again I want to remind you, in a scalar quantity it is specified by single number and proper unit, but in vector quantity it is represented by single number with proper unit and with proper direction. It means this vector quantity required magnitude as well as its direction. Now how can we represent any vector? How can we represent any vector? Vector is represented with the help of a line with the arrowhead. These all vectors are represented with the help of a line, single line with the arrowhead. So this vector is represented like this. This is known as the tail of the vector. This tail of the vector represents its magnitude. It explains about the length of the tail, it explains about the magnitude of the vector, and this head, this arrowhead, this is the arrowhead or head of the vector, represents about the direction of vector or physical quantity. So this is the representation of vector. Whenever you want to represent any vector, we simply represent like this. So this is the tail of the vector and this is the head of the vector. This tail represents its magnitude and this head represents its direction of the vector. So now, what are the types of vector? These all vectors are classified into two groups. First, all the vectors are classified into two groups, and they are polar vector and next is the axial vector. What is this polar vector? This vector which have point of application. It means this polar vector, it has its point of application. Suppose that if I am writing like this, so this particle, suppose that this is any force. I want to represent any force. So this force is representing like this because this is the point of origination and this is the point of application. So this particle applying force over this. So this is the point of application. So that all the force and velocity and these all things are represented by this polar vector. Now examples are displacement, velocity, force. These all are the polar vector. Now next is the axial vector. Axial vector related to the motion, rotation of the particle. Those vectors which represent the rotational effect and act along the axis of rotation. Suppose that this is any disc. This is any disc, and if I rotate it, then this particle rotating clockwise rotation, and this is the axis of this disc. So this is the example of axial vector. Your ceiling fan is also example of axial vector. This is hang, the ceiling fan is hang with the ceiling and it rotated about its axis. That is also an example of this. Your angular velocity is example of axial vector. Angular acceleration is example of your axial vector. Torque is example of axial vector. Here you can, these are the diagram we are given. This disc is rotated clockwise direction and this is rotated anti-clockwise direction. So what is the direction? If any particle is rotating clockwise and any particle is rotating anti-clockwise, then what is the direction of this axial vector? So you should know that we have a right hand thumb rule. This right hand thumb rule is very best method to find out the direction of axial vector. Because in polar vector it is already specified the particle is moving in which direction. But in axial vector, if the particle is rotating and does not displacing its position from one point to another point, then how can you able to find out the direction? So we have this method. If the particle is more rotating, if the particle is rotating just like this, it means anti-clock, then the direction of this is upward. Suppose that this is the pen and if it is rotating, and if this pen is rotating just like this one, here you can see that if this particle is rotating anti-clock, then if we hold like our hand in such a way, so this curved finger shows the direction of the motion, direction of the rotational motion, and this thumb shows the direction of axial vector. So if the particle rotating anti-clockwise, then its direction is upward direction, and if the particle is rotating clockwise direction, then its direction is downward direction. So for this it is clockwise direction, so its direction is downward, and if it is anti-clock, so its direction is upward. How? You can see here, just like this, if I rotate like this our hand, so if I rotate just like this, so our thumb is going downward, so this is the direction of axial vector, and here, if I rotate our hand like this, so this is going upward, so this is the direction of axial vector. So by right hand thumb rule, we can find the direction of axial vector. So these are the two vectors, two types of vector. Then, if you solve some problem with the vector, then there are various types of vector exist. So we are going to see here, these are the various types of vector. One by one we are going to define these all vectors. So first of all, these are the definitions. We are going to study about the definition of vector algebra. So here, first we will study about the equal vector. What is this equal vector? Equal vector are those vectors which have equal magnitude, which have same magnitude and same direction. They are known as equal vectors. Suppose this is the vector A and this is the vector B. So these two vectors have equal direction and equal magnitude, they are known as equal vector. It's a really very simple. Equal vector, it means all things are equal, same magnitude as well as same direction, they are known as equal vector. Next is the, this is negative vector. Second is the negative vector. Negative vector is also known as the unequal vector or negative vector. Negative vector, why it is known as negative vector? It means, suppose this is the two vector, this is the vector A and this is the vector B. Then these two vector having equal magnitude but opposite direction, then they are known as negative vector. So if these vectors are represented like this one, if these two vectors are represented like this one, then these are known as these two unequal vectors. So we can write here this vector A is equal to minus vector B. So this showing that these two vectors have equal magnitude and this negative sign shows that it has opposite direction. So this is also known as the negative vector or unequal vector. Third is the co-initial vector. Third is co-initial vector. Co-initial vector. Co-initial vector, it means it defines that co-initial. If the two vector having same starting point, it means if the two vector having same starting point, then they are known as co-initial vector. Just see here, if these are the vector, if this is the vector A, this is the vector B, this is the vector C, then these all vector having same starting point, same origin point, then they are known as co-initial vector. It means if the number of vector having same starting point are known as co-initial vector. Fourth is the co-terminus. Co-terminus. Collinear vector. Collinear vector are those vector if the two vector or more than two vector having same magnitude or unequal magnitude are working or acting along the same direction or acting parallelly to each other, then they are known as collinear vector. So here you can see this is the vector A and this is the vector B. So this vector A and vector B are known as collinear vector, and it is also known as like parallel vector. When these two vector are working opposite to each other and the angle between them is 180 degree, then they are known as unlike parallel vector. This is simple known as the like vector, this is known as the unlike vector. This angle between this is 180 degree, then you can write down angle is 180 degree between vector A and vector B. Here is vector B and this is vector A, and this angle between two like vector are 0 degree because they are parallel to each other, so they are known as the collinear vector, and they are also known as the like vector. It means like parallel vector. Parallel vector having 0 degree angle between them and this 180 degree angle between them. Your next is coplanar vector. Coplanar vector. Coplanar vector are those vector which are acting over the same plane, so they are known as coplanar vector. If this is the vector A and this is the vector B, this is the vector C, so this is known as the coplanar vector. These all are working over the same plane, so they are known as the coplanar vector. Now, next is the localized vector. Localized vector are those vector which have its fixed origin point, they are known as localized vector. It is also known as fixed vector. It is also known as fixed vector because it has fixed origin point. That's why it is known as localized vector or fixed vector. Now next is the unit vector. Next is the Next is your unit vector. Unit vector are those vectors which only shows the direction of the given vector, because it has its unit magnitude, so it is known as unit vector. So unit vector is denoted by cap. This is denoted by the cap. Normal vector is denoted by simple this, and this is the unit vector. This is the unit vector, this is the normal vector. Normal vector written to simply write out the A, that is the also the normal vector. The another definition of unit vector is also what? Unit vector is also written as thus, just like this. This is the, when this given vector is divided by the mode of the given vector, that is known as unit vector. This is what? This is the given vector. This is the modulus of given vector, and it gives us, it gives its magnitude. So this is the unit vector. Unit vector is equal to given vector divided by the magnitude of the vector, that gives the unit vector. This unit vector is very very important when you are going to solve some numerical related to the electricity, related to the force in the class 11 and 12. It is very very important when you are going to solve some numerical. Now next is the position vector. What is this position vector? Position vector. Position vector are those vectors which shows the, which says the, which define the position of the particle, that is known as position vector. So this is the origin point, this is the x-axis, and this is the y-axis, and this is the point P. If you want to find out the position of this vector, then you simply draw a line from this point to this point, then this point showing the position vector of this particle. So this is the, this is represented by R. So this R is the position vector of point P. With this very, with the help of this position vector, we can know the exact location of this particle related to this origin point. What is the length and what is the angle? It means angle of rotation, and the length of this particle can be find with the help of position vector. So next is the displacement vector. The next topic is the displacement vector. If the number of vectors were given, then how can you find out the displacement or distance between them? So this is the one of the methods to find out the displacement vector. Displacement vector is what? This is the displacement vector. Suppose that this is the axis y and axis x, and this is the point P and Q. So first of all, we have to find out the position vector of these two with respect to this point. So this is the position vector R1, and this is the position vector R2. Now we have to find out this. This is the displacement vector. So this displacement vector is equal to R2 minus R1. This displacement vector is equal to R2 minus R1. Simple. We want to find out PQ. So PQ is equal to R2 minus R1. This is R2. This is the R1. So final minus initial is known as the displacement vector. So these are the various kinds of vector which we use in our chapter, which we use in our daily life for finding the various problems, various numericals, various solutions. So these are the vector. In next video lecture, we will discuss about the how to add the number of vector by the simple method, by algebraic method, by parallelogram method. Okay, that's all. Thank you.